When I was growing up back in the dark ages of the 70s and the 80s, we never really heard the word autism. It didn't come in contact with many kids who suffered from the affliction. A recent study from the U.S. Center for Disease Control and Prevention says 1 in 68 American children are on the autism spectrum, a tenfold increase over 40 years. So a simple question then emerges. Why? His new book is Disconnected Kids, the groundbreaking brain balance program for children with autism, ADHD, dyslexia, and other neurological disorders. Pleasure to welcome Dr. Robert Melillo to MidPoint today. Doctor, thanks for joining us.
No, thank you for having me.
It will simply be that question. Do we now hear about it more, or is there a reason why there seem to be so many cases and it's growing?
Yeah, it's a good question, but I think that the data clearly shows that there is an increase in actual cases that never existed before. In one of my books, I went through this in great detail and really did a lot of research. And we can look at about 50% of the increase, as you said, going from 1 in 10,000 30 years ago to now 1 in 68. We can look at about 50% of that, maybe greater awareness, early diagnosis, better recognition. But at least 50% of those cases are unexplained, which means that they're new cases that never existed before.
Do we then have to point perhaps to genetics or perhaps societal inferences, something about where people live, how they live, what they eat? Where do we go from here?
Yeah, if we recognize that there's an increase, then genetics pretty much gets ruled out because you don't see any genetic changes happen that quickly. Changes in genetics need thousands of years. And one of the issues is that you know, the majority of people with something like autism don't have their own children. So, and we see that virtually no parent of a child with autism has autism. So it's not a genetic problem. It's being driven by the environment. And most experts agree that these are just lifestyle. The same things that are driving an obesity epidemic, diabetes, cancer, heart disease, you know, things like diet, lack of exercise, too much time in front of the computer, increased stress, you know, more toxins in our environment. All of that is combining to cause this issue.
So are we talking more nurture rather than nature?
Yes, absolutely. Absolutely. It's the only way we can explain it, that it really, we're not finding, even with 25 years of 95% of our research dollars looking for a genetic mutation, we're not really finding that in the vast majority of cases. So what we're seeing is that environmental influences are influencing gene expression in children in the womb. We know that autism starts in the womb, and most issues like ADHD, dyslexia, almost all of those things start early on, and therefore they are preventable.
Okay, so I've got a little bit over a minute left here, and I know this is tough in 1 minute, but if we're talking about things beginning in the womb, what is it then that prospective mothers and even fathers, for that point, need to do differently, must learn to do differently, in order to at least try and head some of this increase off?
Well, in my book, Autism, the Scientific Truth, which came out in 2013, I describe a whole preconception plan for prospective parents. But the good news is that because it's also environmental, it's something that can be reversed after the womb or after the child is born. So we have brain balance centers across the country. We have 85 centers that are learning centers specifically directed at working with children with these types of disabilities. Also, my book, Disconnected Kids, which just came out last month, is a home program that parents can use. And it's been shown, we have scientific studies that have shown that it can completely eliminate things like ADHD and dyslexia.
But the parents have to listen, and they have to get to their doctors, I believe, very briefly, within 2 years, correct? First 2 years of the child's life?
No, you know, we're finding now that the brain is very plastic. The idea of neuroplasticity means that we can change the brain at any time, and we can turn genes that are off on at any time as well. So, you know, we're much more hopeful, and you know, if the parents really are aggressive and utilize things in my book or check out our centers, they can go to brainbalancecenters.com or they can check out my website, drrobertmelillo.com, and they can find out more information about how to help their kids.
We will push them there as well. The book is Disconnected Kids. Fascinating. Much work needs to be done. Dr. Robert Melillo, thank you so much for joining us today. We will stay in touch. And MidPoint will continue.
Thank you so much.